Having fine wherever you find yourself. My name indeed is Sammy Ofosuni. The show is the Ultimate Sports here on HS Television. Today is going to be fun pack. Guess what? Let me just run you through my very synopsis. Today we start with the bout. Yes, the big bout that everybody's talking about. Talking about Patrick Allotey against Jimie Maguey all the way in the US of A. That's how come the Ghana Boxing Supporters Union are here to make sure that, of course, we get into our rhythm. Then, of course, we'll give you a little bit of the EPL, you know, the European League just commenced. Then, of course, we talk about Kotoko, who are also trying to play in Africa. There's a lot in stock for you. And later on, we have some very interesting packages for you. So it's a fun pack show. I don't want to take the win out of the sale. So just stay tuned because it's going to be fun pack. GBSU, take us home. Let's have fun. Once again, let's go.
I'm sorry. Bedimija Son HSTV. As a business owner, wouldn't you want the fastest and the easiest way to help increase sales? It is for this reason we bring you the Bedimija Son HSTV. The Bedimija Show is the newest and the most affordable telemarketing program that gives you the opportunity to advertise your products and services with no hassle. Thinking how? It's easy, Kra. All you need to do is to call us and we will come to your shop or to your company to take videos of the kind of products or services you offer and broadcast it on HSTV so people can know about your existence as a company to help increase sales. Remember that the Bedimija Trail is on the move. So let your shop or your company be our next stop by calling us on 024-8057-024 or 024-0300-507 and we will come to help you advertise your products and services with me, your host, Efio Fusia. It's the Bedimijo, it's the Bedimija Show on HSTV.
High school TV,
education, entertainment, high school life,
we got it all covered.
You're watching high school news, bringing you what's trending, good and bad on various campuses.
High school TV. High school TV.
The egg and chicken, which comes first?
All right, Meru. I'm coming in time. This is the Ghana. See, I walk for the Kenya Hall.
High school TV. Who is the best?
Watching high school TV. Let's go get
high school TV. 开心什么好
of Queens. My name is Jeffrey Norte, the host for Do TV.
Hi everybody, this is Dr. Sonny Badu.
My name is Ohinere Gifty Auntie and I want to urge you to keep on watching Do TV.
The person will share Do TV.
Do TV.
A drop of blessing. Life, I will trust in you
alone. My name is Dr. Lawrence Tete. I recommend you to tune in to Do TV.
You still welcome back. The show still remains the ultimate sports here on HS Television. My name still remains Sami Ofosunyeni. Today is a marathon of a show. Definitely, we're going to do that because it's packed. It's packed, yes. But before I even go ahead with the show, let me introduce to you my guest. Sitting next to me is a man who needs no introduction. Denis Oblogomo, head of sports here, and you know him, communication director. No, secretary general, right?
Sure.
For Ghana Cycling. Sitting next to him is the general of all sports. I need to look. If you don't know this, but definitely you don't know Ghana sports. That's Samuel Haywood Okan, the general one himself. General, very much welcome to the show. Because here we do more local content, I'm going to have to rush through the EPO very, very quickly so that we get a bite of it. Remember, the show is much more interactive, so get interactive on my line on 024430-6426. It doubles as a WhatsApp line. Kindly don't call me on that line. So this is how we're going to go about it. Talking about today's fixtures, you have Liverpool playing against Newcastle United, Brighton and Hove Albion when they take Burnley. Elsewhere, you have Manchester United pitting their horns against Leicester City, Sheffield United will play against Southampton. Tottenham will welcome Crystal Palace. You have Wolverhampton Wanderers play against Chelsea, and that match will be something else because this is a team that do not lose at home. So Norwich will also play against Manchester City. That's talking about today's matches. Let me just run you through the Serie A, where there's a lot happening. Let's go to the Spanish La Liga first. It's Real Madrid will be pitting their horns against Levante. You have Leganés playing against Villarreal. Real Sociedad will play against Atletico Madrid. Barcelona will play against Valencia. And remember, it is without Lionel Messi. So if you want to bet, you know where to bet. You have to be very careful when you're betting. Like they say, bet responsibly. Then, of course, we move to Italy, where you have Fiorentina playing against Juventus. Napoli will pit their horns against Sampdoria. And International Milano will play against Udinese. So that's it for you. Then let's go straight to the German Bundesliga, where today you have Cologne playing against Borussia Mönchengladbach. Union Berlin will play against Werder Bremen. Mainz will play against Hertha BSC. Borussia Dortmund will play against Bayern Leverkusen. Augsburg will play also against Eintracht Frankfurt. Then last but not the least, talking about today's fixtures, it's Leipzig playing against Bayern Munich. So that will be a very, very interesting encounter. With the French Ligue 1 is there already runaway leaders. Paris Saint-Germain will be playing against Strasbourg. Dijon will play against Nimes. You have Bordeaux playing against Mentz. Montpellier will play against Nice. And of course, Brest will also pit his horns against Rennes. So that's it for you, talking about the European side of competition. But Dennis Moore is here. Sammy here with Okan too is here, and like I told you, get interactive on my line on 0244 306426. We're going to talk about Kumasi Asante Kotoko, and it will be very, very quick. First of all, Kumasi Asante Kotoko are playing on Sunday against Etoile du Sahel. Dennis Moore, what are their chances?
Well, Sammy, I think briefly, playing against, you know, this Maghrebian side, you know, has been very, very, very torrid, you know, for Ghanaian clubs, you know, for the past 10 years. And clearly, you know, Etoile are such a stubborn side, you know, in their last game, they won by 7-1, and it actually sends a signal to Kotoko for them to get prepared on Sunday. But of course, I'm a Ghanaian, and I mean, what else? You know, we also saw what Kotoko did, you know, in the last, Confederations Cup. Playing against the likes of Nkana and all that, I really love the way they played. And if they're really going to, you know, transform that kind of play, I mean, onto the pitch on Sunday, then let's say Kotoko can just run away with maybe one or two goals.
That's according to Dennis Oblogomo. I'll tell you how I got the Oblogomo on a later part of the. But of course, Sammy is here. Sammy, it's Ash Gold, who are also playing against JS Bekani. If you watch Ash Gold, are they battle ready for this competition?
Because if you look at their previous matches, they've been playing very well and they've been scoring. So, but Kotoko, if they score one or two, it's not good. They can score about three. That will make them comfortable. But if they score one or two, they go there to be tough for them. But let me congratulate the teachers too for qualifying to the
It's good you ship that in because I would have skipped it.
Last week we bashed them. But bashing them as the positive, because after bashing them, they realized that they must do better.
Absolutely. You think that worked, eh?
It was constructive criticism.
Absolutely. I think, I was telling you, I was at the stadium myself. I watched the way they played against the Nigerians. I wasn't satisfied, but of course, I was so much, you know, I mean, amazed when actually I watched them live, you know, how they played against the Nigerians. And the referees and all that were simply against the Ghanaians. But how they came up tops, it's only God.
Yeah.
Indeed. It's only God. So now Sammy will admit that the coach actually is a good coach. Sammy, you confess.
Yeah.
Okay, if the general has laid down his gauntlets, then there is nothing again to talk about.
And move forward and try and qualify at the African Championship in Egypt and go to Tokyo. Like I said, Tokyo is all where we are going to show our skills in football again. So these materials are very good. So government should help them. So they go to Tokyo, they qualify in Egypt and go to Tokyo and go and bring another medal for us.
Okay. So that's it there. But of course, we'll bring our next segment of the show all together. What it is that we are going to go for the WISA Games. I hope my producer is ready. There was a WISA award which was launched at the Accra Sports Stadium. Of course, our cameras were there. So my producer tells me that we have challenges here and there too. But Sammy, you were there at the WISA Games. Well, Give us a brief.
It was a lunch.
Okay.
This is our fifth year.
Okay.
And this is the third year for the awards. You know, WISA has come up with a program that every year they honor female people who are doing sports in Ghana. Girls, ladies, women in sports. You know, so anybody who does well in sports will be encouraged and motivated to do better. So this year, and they are honoring 23 people.
Run us through some of the lists.
33, including those who won at the African Games. Winifred Ntumi is there. Obuo, Chris Obuo is there. All those who did well at the African Games, they are there. And other media guys, media girls, or media ladies, like Beatrice Laye, like Equa of TV3, Laurentia of
Edna of Ghana Nisa Jensi.
No, Edna is not in. Edna will get us later on. But Hegaruka.
Hega.
Angela Asante.
Angela.
That girl went to the Russia and France.
Okay.
Women's World Cup. They are all there. So Uza is coming up with a program to honor the female sports personalities.
Okay.
It will be on 28th September at the Casper Stadium.
Okay. But Dennis Moore, I do not understand why we couldn't secure the right to cover the WISA games and whether it was OMI TV. We are the head of sports. Just 1 minute. Talk
anyway,
about it.
Maybe Sami is here. He can actually lay more,
Sami is the editor of Ultimate Sports.
OMI is run by a female. Mm-hmm. He's called Joesaku Mensah.
I trained Joesaku.
Yeah.
So, I trained her.
So the founder of the executive of WISA, that's Madame Komodo.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
She contacted her and she expressed interest in joining her so that they'll do their programs.
But this is the general sports.
Yes, let me come in. You know, OMI Sports director Aku. Aku was under me at TV Africa.
But she beat you to it.
No, she didn't beat me to it. Mm. No, but I give respect to females. So I have no problem with that at all.
Yeah.
But then they should actually expand their coop, when they're actually coaching such female athletes.
Mm.
Yeah. Cycling, we have one lady, Clementina Young.
Okay.
From SS, but for cycling, this girl would have died and would have gotten pregnant. This is what we should look at. Don't talk about winning. You see, Sami,
if I go there, you're not going to
Sami,
I've seen a boxer who is very much pregnant. How about that?
Would you allow me to just give some 10 seconds?
Okay,
10 seconds.
Okay, 10 seconds.
We shouldn't place priority on winning before you send a person.
It's not about winning, excelling.
It's not about excelling. That's an issue.
See,
women are special.
If
they don't excel, you don't call them? Is that the case?
No, others are excelling.
No, my brother.
I'm telling you, between these two guys, if I leave them, we're not finish the show today. But of course,
anyway,
that's it.
Okay.
They say opinions are lower court. They're unpeat. Some stinky others fresh. It's a matter of personal hygiene. Okay. And here, HSTV, we pride ourselves as such. But of course, we do have to go for a quick commercial. But remember, the show is much more interactive, so get interactive on my line 0244-3064-26. I will read all your comments. So keep them coming. But right about now, I do have to go for a quick commercial break. When I'm back, I'll bring you somebody who won gold in the weightlifting division. So stay tuned. I'll be right back.
Entertainment, high school life.
We got it all covered.
You're watching High School News, bringing you what's trending, good and bad on various campuses.
High
School TV. Who is the best?
Watching High School TV.
SPTV.
Let's go get it.
High School TV.
开心什么？
What's up?
up, kings and queens? My name is Jeffrey Norte, the host for DUTV.
Hi, everybody. This is Dr. Sonny Bag.
My name is Ohinenye Giftianti, and I want to urge you to keep on watching DUTV.
The person who shared DUTV.
DUTV.
A drop of blessing. Life, I will trust in you alone.
My name is Dr. Lawrence Tete. I recommend you to tune in to DUTV.
When you move, I move. I will follow you.
Welcome back to the show. It's still the Ultimate Sports here on HS Television. Like I promised you, I have here Christian Amoa. Of course, you see me holding those medals. Interestingly, he's going to tell us about how he was able to secure all these medals. Christian, very much welcome to the studio. Of course, Sami is still here. Sami will be helping me do the questioning. First of all, congratulations. I'm told you just came from Morocco.
Uganda.
What did you go to Uganda to do?
Olympic qualifier, which it was a junior championship, but also an Olympic qualifier.
I'm told you were at the African Games.
Yes.
And you secured a medal. Tell us about
it. I won bronze at the African Games. Before I left for.
You're tired.
I left for.
My producer was punishing
me. The junior championship, which I won the gold medal.
Okay.
This is about 2019 medal.
Yes. Oh, okay.
At the Olympic Games.
And this one is what, if you can just walk me through.
This one is the All African Games medal.
Just ended, yes. All African Games.
Won,
wow.
Medals day.
Yes.
So this one is what? Red. Like, what is it supposed to be? Gold, silver,
bronze. Is bronze.
Bronze. Yeah, okay.
Third place.
Wow. Yeah. Third place. Okay, I'll put this one here. So, I mean, this one too.
You won 3 day.
Three bronze.
Yes. Yeah.
Charlie, you're a big man. You're a big man. A whole GBF, we won one.
Yeah.
Yeah, big man.
I mean, Snow Mesa is doing well.
My
boss.
Ben, yes, yes, Snow Mesa is doing well.
He's our president.
Yeah, and he's the gold.
Okay.
We send gold.
Yeah, this is what I want.
2 days ago.
Weightlifting Federation of Africa. 3 days ago. Tell us about it.
It's African Championship. It's a junior championship, which is Olympic qualifier. So the qualifier, we get a point. So I have to go for 6 competition before qualifying for the Olympics. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. So, I mean, what about the other ones? This one's the same.
Yeah,
you want three?
Three gold.
This guy gave
a that's a 2 place or 40 place. They can't even win one a bronze. But one with if that win three.
You as amazing. But tell us, how did you develop the interest for it? Let's know you. Who are you? Tell us about you.
You know, first I started weightlifting. I was playing football, but not this. This house football before I met Ogbodu, who is our former coach. And then he introduced me to weightlifting. That's when I started lifting. I found interest in it because I love going to the gym also. So that's where I found interest. And then I had a passion for it.
Wow, Sam.
Were you at the last Olympics in
2016?
2016, was it in Brazil? You were
Yes.
And how was it? And when did you go to those Olympics too? So tell us how you feel.
For the 2016 Olympics, I would say I went there for exposure, just to know how the grounds are. So now I'm back to, on my feet to make sure I do something better this coming Olympic Games. So I need Ghanaians to support me to achieve my dream.
Can you promise Ghanaians that you're going to win or probably go to the Olympics?
I won't promise Ghanaians that I'm going to bring medal, but I'll do my best to, achieve something better.
We hope your best is enough. So, maybe you shoot one, two story, yeah?
Weightlifting, do you feel the media have exposed you like you wanted or something?
The media...
No, they will do football. Do you think that?
Some of your answer is the question for you. I'm not letting you
the bigger guys are trying, but not as much as they do to the footballers. Because, you know, they say footballers, football is the passion of the nation. But when you go through this, let's say this year or last year, like, Whitlifting is doing a lot better. Because football went to the African Games and it didn't do nothing. But just me, I went to this African Games. I won 3 medals. After that, I went to Uganda and then I brought them 3 gold medals. So wow. You can see how weightlifting is
so,
doing.
You know, congratulations.
Do you get money? Is it rewarding?
We don't get anything.
Really?
Yes, we don't really get anything. We are just, I think we are volunteering. We are not getting anything. I mean,
but with the competition, when you went, they gave you something, some bonus.
No.
You won gold and they didn't give you anything.
It's only the
rabats.
They gave us bonus. I went to Malaysia 2016, I brought gold, they didn't give me anything. I came back to Uganda again, I won 1 gold, 1 silver, 1 bronze, they didn't give me anything.
Wow, and the messages are coming thick and fast. We are very much grateful. But see, you just secured yourself a whole show. According to my producer, we're going to have you in studio hopefully next week, and it will be uninterrupted, just yourself.
Okay.
So we're very grateful once again. And we hope to see you. That not to waste about it. So right about now, we do have to go for a quick commercial break. Once again, when I'm back, we continue with the show. We'll be right back after this commercial. So yeah.
Thinks I'm playing video games.
My big sis thinks I'm on WhatsApp.
Daddy thinks I'm on Instagram.
It's biology.
It's chemistry.
Chemistry on your phone. That's new.
Mm-hmm.
Daddy, it's physics.
Watch it carefully. I'm going to swing it to perform horizontal circle, or to describe a horizontal circle.
Visual learning at home makes learning in school so easy. Subscribe to LearnRight video lectures today and fall in love with learning. Visit the following post offices to copy LearnRight video lectures and learn without internet. You can also place an order and it will be delivered at your doorstep by Ghana Post. Call us on 0302-942-432 or 0557-942-055 or WhatsApp LearnRight on 0557-942-055. LearnRight. Fall in love with learning.
Yes. Yeah. Then it's more an ever talkative Sami Heiwudu kind. Of course, they are still talking, as you can hear the two of them at the background. But of course, the show still remains Ultimate Sports here on HS Television. Your messages are coming thick and fast, and I'll try and read like four or five. This one is saying, great show. I always love your content. I think that your time should be increased to 2 hours. I'm not sure my people will be happy with you on that one. This one is saying, Sami, I love your show. Please give credence to EPL and let's see highlights. Okay, but you see, we do more how do you call local content, well. So that's the thing. It's and the show is 60% boxing. That's one I, you know,
besides Manchester not performing, so I mean, why should we?
I don't know, but it's more supporting Manchester United.
No, I'm an Arsenal fan anyway.
Okay. So I'm trying to get the messages here, but even that, let's talk about the main thing. Of course, I'm sure you know that Patrick Allotey, yeah, the poisonous arrow, the sweet arrow, whichever you choose to call him, still remains Patrick Allotey. Yeah, he is at the forefront this night. I must say, it will be very interesting in the far away US of A. What is happening is that Patrick must beat the defending champion, Jimie Maguey. Yes, he is a Mexican, and of course, he's the defending champion, and he's also undefeated, so it's going to be something else. Patrick has tasted defeat 3 times. Of course, we all know what happened, and still, we know Patrick to be a formidable side. First of all, as you can see on the background, that was the press conference. I don't know if we'll go check that one out, or probably we should talk even as. But first of all, Dennis, what you see Patrick Allotey and Jimie Maguey?
Well, something I think that.
Let's be realistic. You're a Ghanaian, but be realistic. Does he have a chance to beat him?
Well, in boxing, some of you and I know that I don't predict based on patriotism. I predict based on statistics and what you know, a boxer can really do in the ring. Now, this goes to, I mean, for us to compare the two pugilists in the ring, you know, Maguey and, of course, Allotey. And, you know, since Allotey actually dethroned Frank Doji, you know, going ahead, of course, to defend title twice, you know, he actually got a chance to take up this scrap. Now, the whole issue is that Allotey, the last time he came over to the studios, that was last week, you can see that he's actually very prepared mentally and physically. Now, until I just saw, you know, a publication on Ghana Web just a few minutes ago, Patrick again himself was saying that he feels that the absence of his coach, who was denied a visa to the US, is going to affect him. I just read it. You know, so if a boxer is going to a fight of this kind, and you begin to, you know, say words of this caliber, even to your fans and all that. So, I mean, look, those of us who write sport boxing will also have a different impression of the fight. But see, you can't take Patrick's, beautiful boxing stints in the ring. It is there, all right. I want him to take that thing out of his mind, go into the ring and do what he can do. Now, Maguey is not a cheap meat at all, just like you know, he's a knockout specialist. And I also read, you know, he really actually wants to move up in weight, notwithstanding, after this fight, to the middleweight division.
Somebody also say that he's moving up in weight because he's afraid. I mean, his plan has been found out. His last fight against Hogan,
yeah,
you realize how he struggled. For many, he lost that particular encounter. So people are saying that fighting Patrick Allotey is actually like a face saving. What he doesn't know is that Patrick Allotey is also a different customer altogether. But let's talk about Patrick Allotey and the preparations towards this fight. People feel that he didn't go there early. What do you think about that before I go to general?
For me, I also really do think, especially, you know, I actually went into the books and I found so many things, you know, that can really affect Patrick Allotey. For example, the coaching issue. You know, he being trained by one coach for so many times, and then quickly another person comes in to take him over. I think it is managerial ineptitude, on that count. Look, if a coach is training this guy, why don't you allow the coach to just move with Allotey? You know, until at the 11th hour, and then you drop the coach, you know, based on many reasons. I think it is psychologically very, very, you know, effective on this count. We can't take this away from this fight, it's clear. But as a Ghanaian, I will want to see Allotey win this fight. If the fight is to travel, now I'm predicting as a boxing Ghana analyst. Now, what I see, if this fight goes beyond round 7 or 8, right? I see Allotey not being knocked out.
Okay.
He wouldn't be knocked out, but the fight might go in the way of Maguey through a decision or something. Remember, he's a champ.
Yes.
And you can't easily just run over him like that. But Ghana must put up a show for him to know the world is not watching him. You know, funny Ghanaian boxer, I think 30 out of 26 wins, right?
No, for 33 bouts. Mm. For, I mean, for Allotey, something.
Allotey has chopped 40
something. Yeah, 40. But I think it's not. I think his knockout percentage, as compared to Mangaya, I mean, it's better. Mm. You know, so I'm actually wanting to go into this fight with that. I mean, perfect record. So operate for Allotey, and you're actually rooting for him.
Okay, so this one said, I beg, tell the man, I'm 29, and I want to be like him. My name is Simon. I think that he's talking about the weightlifting guy. This one is saying that, ask the GBSU, why is it that they don't go out and support the boxers? They should be doing that. That is very important. You didn't add your name. I don't know. Okay, so this one is saying, okay, I am John Aqua from Nyanyo. I think that Ghana should do well. I don't know what Ghana should do well in, but we'll see how. Maybe you're talking about the Ghanaian clubs in Africa. Okay, I'm hoping that they also do Kotoko Ash Gold. Let's see. Let's see how they do well in that particular contract. This one is saying that the archaic bureaucracy in our clubs is what is not helping Ghanaian football clubs. I think that Kumasi Asante Kotoko must better be aware of the Etoile side. They are a very good side. Okay, so but Sammy,
You know,
let me
this fight, Allotey's fight.
Yes, let me ask you this. Allotey was here last week. We interviewed him, and he said it's that look, he's going to go there and prove that yes, he is a boxer to reckon with.
As at last week, he knew he was not going with his coach. He knew.
Okay.
And when they were filing for the visa, the coach was in Rabat.
Yeah, the coach was in Ghana. Yeah.
So getting him a date for the interview for the visa was a problem with it. You know. They are the management of Allotey doesn't issue the visa.
That's true. The embassy.
They file the application for the visa, but they have the power to give the date or the visa.
So why didn't the assistant coach go? Because I know he was the one taking care of Patrick Allotey.
Okay, I don't know why he didn't go.
Exactly.
I don't know why. The assistant coach should have gone. Or that's why I say planning and preparation is very important in sports. If you don't prepare and plan well,
you start to fail. There's this message, and I think that it's for you. I said I was not going to read it, but I think that is for you. He says that, Sammy. Not that I don't like Coach Asare. I think that something must be done. As in, why is he the one handling professional boxers and at the same time the junior team?
It's not good. That was, people have talked about it so many times. And at times, if you are coaching both professional and amateur, you can mix it up and it's not good. Because if you are an amateur, you must be fast. That's why some of our amateur boxers, they fight like professionals. And they lose. And they fight like they are on top of the game. You know, which is not good. Mm-hmm. If you're an amateur, fight as an amateur. Go all out. Don't feel like a professional. So when they train with professionals, they think they are professionals. So they fight like professionals, which is not good at all. It affects our boxers. And when they lose, they don't know why they lost. Because they feel like professionals. Professional fighting is different from amateur fighting.
Interesting. Yeah. But Sammy, can
and with the other fight, there are two titles at stake.
Yes.
They don't be
the Mayan.
Mayan.
Yeah, and that's WBO. A big title.
A beautiful title.
The Mexicans came out with that.
Against Allotey. The weight, the fans, the place, everything is against Allotey.
But let me ask you, it is the Mexican Independence Day celebration weekend. Do you think that they will let Patrick Allotey just come and take the title?
It's possible anything can happen.
Okay.
A surprise blow. Can hit the chin, there will be a knockout. Anything can happen in boxing, in sports. So I don't say, my prize is that he wins. As a Ghanaian, I'm pray that he wins. Mm. But everything is against him. But God must do it inside. So let's all pray for Allotey so that he wins.
Interesting. but you see, Sammy, you know, just like Sammy said, in boxing, anything can happen. A single blow can cause an upset. But there is an element called experience. Now, if you watch Kovalev against Iyad, I think last 2 weeks. Yeah. So what happened?
I was very disappointed in Yad.
So this is what I'm talking about. Mangaya is an experienced boxer.
Allotey is more experienced than him.
You know, and if
you're a fought more than him.
Absolutely. No, it's not about the issue of you are fought faulty. But the credible of boxers you have actually fought against is key.
Yeah.
And if I compare the two, Mangaya has an advantage over the quality of boxers.
Yeah.
You know, especially if it was after Frank Doji. Who did he fight? I mean, I think Kumbasa also.
He was also fighting. This fight came on. So they.
Okay, yeah. You see, I'm not taking anything away from the Ghanaian. All that we want is that, look, my Nigeria side, I think we are failed. Okay. Because Sammy is saying that, look, Allotey knew that he wasn't going to go with the coach. A week back.
Yeah.
So, I mean, how can that be?
I knew.
So if he knew,
Why then is he now complaining on Ghana Web?
No, that's just that's what he wrote.
No. Was there a quote? Hold on.
This was a quotation.
We'll try and get to the bottom of that.
No,
but of course, let me guess.
It's in quotes.
It's in quotes, but that's how the person wrote it.
If you're actually oblivious,
it's a direct statement.
Okay, so I told you where these guys meet. It's fireworks. Yes. Right? So if you're oblivious of what we're talking about, simply what we're saying, what we're actually trying to analyze Patrick Allotey's bout. Of course, the Ghana Boxing Supporters, you know, are here to give morale support. Yes. So we'll have them very, very soon. But just by way of records, Patrick Allotey has won 40 times. He's lost 3. Of course, 30 of those 40 victories came by way of KO. So he's a very, very good boxer. The fact is that he's going against a boxer who is 3 inches taller than him. And a boxer who was actually even overweight. By two, right?
Yeah,
2 pounds. And he had to shed it off by actually doing some jogging here and then stripping naked as well. So you can see. And there's something about Mexican boxers, and let's face it, they cheat most of the times.
Yeah.
That's how come they don't like the WBC, because they are subject to a lot of checks and all that. So, I mean, you watch Patrick Allotey, you watch his demeanor.
It's not only about Mexican boxers. We need to be fair to them. I don't think it's only about Mexican boxers.
Noted for that.
Even Ghanaian boxers.
That is why Canelo can go and cow meat and say that.
Fury has cheated before.
Fury went through a depression where he was actually taking
Joshua. Joshua has even cheated before.
It's part of the game.
It's part of the game. He did it before that. Okay. Let's go, Jimie Maguey. I mean, he's actually won 33 times. Yes, he's never tasted defeat before. Those 33 times, he won 26 by way of KOs. Guess what? His last fight against that English boy, Dennis Hogan. He struggled. Dennis Hogan is not so much of an exceptional boxer. That's what makes some of us have a lot of faith and a lot of belief. But Sammy, Patrick Allotey went very late.
Talk about Buku Banku. Mm.
Yes, Banku won and then he's in town. We're trying to get him to
give a shout out to Banku Charlie. Everybody was.
Yes. Yes. So, Buku Banku, very much welcome back to Ghana. He's actually the WBU. International welterweight. Cruiserweight. Yeah. Okay, cruiserweight champion.
He'll be defending in October in the USA.
Isn't it too soon?
Well, that's what they said, but...
Anyway, Navarrete is fighting tonight after winning his bout as well just last month on the 17th. He's fighting tonight, so I guess it comes with the territory.
Yes, I mean, yeah, talking about the Allotey's fight, you know, and talking about Mungaya for that matter, you know, he actually fought Takeshi Inoue even before taking on Daniel Hogan, and that fight was very superlative performance from the Mexican. So if we are to judge, you know, what really transpired in the Hogan fight, I don't think, you know, it's actually falls within the realm. Let's take it, from statistics in the books. Mungaya is a quality boxer by all standards. Indeed, you can have your day and all that, you know, but clearly, on paper, Mungaya really stands tall in that stance. But we're just praying that the Ghana will actually take his new chances and make Ghana proud in the ring on that day. I don't want to see him knocked out. That's my prayer. I don't want to see Allotey knocked out. Just go all out and finish the 12 rounds. That's it.
You know, Allotey said when he's winning, he knows. Allotey, he said...
That's an experienced boxer.
He knows.
West Sada is working with his coach. Yeah.
Because
they work together. If he knows that he's winning, the coach will, they all make some signals and they fight on. And West Sada, Asai is not going. All they say, wish him well. Wish him well. That he makes Ghana proud.
Odamite is a good coach, isn't he?
Odamite is a good coach.
But telepathy counts, you know.
Telepathy counts. It's a long time by training somebody. It's a long time.
Yeah, you know.
Because he hasn't been doing the work often.
Yeah.
Has been a break.
Do I get a sense of pessimism from the two of you?
Oh, it's not that pessimism, but we are saying reality.
Fantastic. That's the point.
Sammy, I'm putting it to you, like a lawyer. Who is winning that fight?
My heart is...
Why do you pause?
My heart is with Allotey, but my head may be with Maguire.
Then it's more. I'm putting it to you. Who is winning that fight? Sammy, because we are going to have the Ghana Boxing Supporters Union executives here.
Sammy, yes.
And talk to them before we wrap up.
Based on statistics and based on ring, you know, qualities. And from the curriculum vitae of both boxers, Mungaya will win on the day, but he will win through unanimous decision. Watch it. Clear.
Wow. But there's a topic I want us to talk, just 1 minute each. Look, I saw Oscar De La Hoya, and I asked myself, where is the likes of Aikote and all that? Why are they promoting our boxing? What is the problem?
No, X had a promotion company.
What happened?
I had problem with, I don't know, the boxers. You know, Ghana boxes are very difficult to deal with.
No, he can introduce that into the system. Mexican boxes are same. They take drugs here and there. You have to control them. Check their... It's not easy.
But we are different, you know.
Golden Boy is a different guy. He even said he's going to be American president.
Yeah, but that one, they've thrown it to the dogs. It's not easy.
No, he has the ambitions. It is there. It is there.
They think big, they create big, they everything big.
They create big.
Yeah. He wants to be American president. Mm. But the government board promotion, they are doing well.
So I think that I have to go for a quick commercial break when we are back. Definitely. Okay, so the Boxing Supporters Union are actually going to file in, even as we're still having the show. So, I was hoping that we have a quick break
for them,
but it seems my producer wouldn't have any of that. Okay, so Sammy, come closer to me. I would Fuseni. I want to have a chat with him and Sammy as well. Maybe you get closer to me here. If you can just get here. Of course. Then. He's a promoter, matchmaker. This man, you have to look out. You know, those people who've been sending a message, they want managers and they want a good boxing gym to train and all that, from Kumasi, Takoradi, and Tamale. Get in touch with him. You know, he will actually sort you out. Your Facebook page is what?
Dawuda Fuseni.
Dawuda Fuseni. So check him out. Dawuda Fuseni. The Fuseni is Fuseni.
N-I.
Yeah. Oh, okay. N-I. Okay. So you have it there. That's it. But of course, I want to have a chat with you before they take us home. Dawuda, Ghana Boxing Supporters. Look, I'm getting tons of messages. The fact that you people are not, though you are active, you're not really active when it comes to going outside to support boxers. What is the problem? Tell me here, now.
Yeah, Sammy, thank you very much. This situation has been a very compounding one. We have lamented a couple of times on the ministry and then the government to support us in this cause, but it seems nothing is coming out of it. And it is very shameful because we can't be just around, you know, making noise, shouting without support. You see, sports is all about morale.
Sure.
You understand? So if it comes to that aspect, we need to follow them wherever they go.
Yeah.
Give them the needed morale. It is something that they need. You see, just a moment ago when, you know, this dancing was going on, the flute, the, you know, the drums, you were having some feel in you.
Yeah, the feeling was big, man.
You understand? So likewise, the same thing happens to the athletes. So when they get that feeling, that morale, you know, the sounds, the drums, they feel so strong within them.
Let me ask you.
They bring out their best.
What is the other supporters union doing that you are not doing? Because you are supposed to be taking all the bosses everywhere. What are they doing that you are not doing?
Sammy, actually, this question, I don't know. Because we are doing, virtually everything. We are doing everything that needs, you know, to take us there.
Let me put a challenge to you.
Okay.
And of course, we'll follow it here on Ultimate Sports, HS Television. Yeah. Yes. We should come and we're fighting.
Mm.
Okay, we'll be fighting in December.
Yeah.
So let me say, as the Douglas one is a bit closer, so we'll take that one aside. We should come and we're fighting in December. I want to see you people in the US of A. We're going to follow that thing through here. We're going to also follow up with the sports ministry as well. So
as well,
let's
see how.
Yes, as well as the embassy.
That would be lovely.
Can I take you on that?
That would be lovely. That will be lovely.
We are going to take you on that.
Because we are ever ready, we are set to go. You understand? But the support isn't coming. The ministry, because I remember in, 2016, when he was to fight Easter.
Okay.
We made that attempt. We followed up to the ministry. We went there, here and there. You know, what happened there was so, you know, pathetic. It was so bad. You understand? Because by then, it was Neil Ante Van Der Poel. We went to him. Could you imagine that he had to tell us we should go to the secretary, and he has left everything to the secretary? At a point in
time,
telling you.
Really?
At a point in time, the secretary told us that she's going to hand over everything to us for us to make the follow-up from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs.
Wow.
You understand? So the support isn't there. The support isn't there. And this is what the athletes need. They need our support. So the government or the sector ministry should support. They should come in to give us the adequate support that we need.
Okay.
Yeah, no, because we are doing our best.
But I'm taking you on the coming one. So that one, I definitely am the one going to follow up on that. And of course, the two of us will do that. But
that will be lovely.
Atai is here. Hey, Atai Muamasi.
Yeah.
I nearly gave you a different name altogether. That's Atai Mu. You see, what you didn't know about the Ghana Boxing Supporters Union is that these are very ready-made people, business people, politicians. Some of them are even owners of hotels and stuff. These are guys, some matchmakers, promoters. So we're not talking about just any ordinary people. We're talking about people of substance. And that's what you didn't know. Unlike any other supporters union. So it's imperative that definitely we support them. These people actually want to push the flag of Ghana high. But Atamu, probably you tell me a bit about what you people are doing, even tonight for Patrick Allotey. Quick one.
Yeah, first of all, let me just send a quick congratulations to Ghana Matthews for qualifying to the Africa, what do you call it?
Youth tournament.
Youth tournament, because they really done very well.
Mm.
Yeah. You know, we are there to support. You know, most of the time, they need support.
Mm.
So we are ready, ever ready to support them wherever they are going. We are ever ready. And tonight, I think we are going to do some small bonfire for our brother. Because most of the time when they hear that we are doing bonfire for them, it has its own way to ginger them, you know, about, you know, while fighting, thinking how that, I think there's something.
Yeah, there's some support coming in there.
Coming straight, okay. Yeah. So we are doing a lot tonight for them.
Next to Attire Moore is Francis Loco. Fred Loco. I nearly gave him you know Francis Loco died not too long ago. May his soul rest in peace, of course. But this man is a senior brother of Carl Lawrence Loco. Yes, you wouldn't believe it. He's handsome than Carl Loco. I mean it's no secret.
Yeah.
First of all, where would you say to augment that? Because I'm putting a challenge on you guys that you're gonna support Rishi come December. What assurances can you give me? Because I'm gonna follow through on that.
Well, boxing is our business. And we have volunteered ourselves that you are going to follow boxing. Come with me, whoever you are, whether you are a boxer in Ghana, we are with you. Whatever you are going to do to bring us glory, that is what we are standing for. So wherever that we are going or whatever that we are doing in the name of Ghana boxing. Yeah. We are not doing it for any other person or any other individual. All that we are doing as Ghana Box Supporters Union is support Ghana boxing to the greatest height. That is all that we are looking at.
And your messages are still coming thick and fast. Forgive me, I can't read all of them. But this is the man. This is the man who I'm told is now the acting presido. You should see him. I mean, a good drama. No two ways about it. He calls himself the wise man. He's the wise. Maybe probably he'll give me his name. Nana Jan is what I know him by. They call him the wise. Nana, what would you say to everybody that we wrap up?
I have something.
First of all, attack everybody. Min damo fi mo shi correct as no we we look at that letter.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Then we go back front le on me. One damo fi mo shi. Ni ko Ghana Boxing Supporters Senior. We be ke ha bukumpe alo gape. She we fake ha deo Ghana. Mo pa mo fi mo fai. Ake mo fi mo ba fit away. Ni ke wa le ke kon ba fit away. If it go government ke ministry say me wa what we you. She will like a distance around that mawo. Pa mucho bibri Kumasi for mo mo north bibia mo bi a mo fa support embra na mo fa tire chi because Ghana Boxing Supporters Union obi ase enja boxing ye from 24/7 ye boxing how much ya no anopa nti bibia san ye wo mochi wo bibia mo
for sure for sure doctor the final comment.
Yeah, I would like to take this platform to congratulate the Black Meteors for qualifying to the African Youth Championship. And then also, we'd like to urge the ministry that we are there. If they need our support, I mean, probably to go to Egypt to support them, we are there. We are ever ready because we are pushing up to the, Olympic Games. Then also, we'd like to use the same platform to congratulate Bukom Banku for, winning the WBU International Cruiserweight title. Then also, we'd like to, use this platform to wish our very own Patrick Allotey a very best of luck in tonight's game. Because it's not going to be easy, my brother. That fight is not going to be easy, but he needs to pull his weight. Because when you look, or when you based on analysis, everything goes to his disadvantage.
Yeah, he's an underdog.
So we all pray, for him to come out successful.
Of course. So just to make sure that Patrick's morale is high in the US of A, we're going to start from here. This is spirit. It's going to go through the air. Yes. So GBSU, take us home. My name has been Samino Fosuyine. do join me same time next week. I was here with Dennis Oblogomo, Sammy Hewudokan. We even had the champion weightlifter, Christian Amo as well. So do join us same time next week. It's been a blast. Many thanks to the production team, Reverend Ampofo. Remember that you can watch the repeat of the show on Andy Glow TV and, of course, Boxing Ghana TV as well. So that's it for you. We are back same time next week. GBSU, take us home. Give me some morale. Thank you.